My dearest, I only hope you can forgive me. It was, I think, the only cowardly act of my life. But when I came to tell her, I suddenly knew that I could not. I am so sorry.
Someone will have to pay.
I shall never forget the years of danger that we shared together. Whatever happens to us in the future, if we never see each other again, you will always be in my heart.
Someone will have to pay.
What we must remember is the passion we have known and what we have achieved together. I love you, and that love will not be diminished by separation. I can only hope that you will feel the same way.
Someone will have to pay.
What is it, Mum? Not another of those letters.
It's a mistake, Daisy. Just a stupid mistake. Some crank or other. We should ignore them.
Yes, but...
Not another word. Now, is my astrakhan back from the cleaners? I have to go out.
Daunt and Dervish by Guy Meredith. Starring Anna Massey as Josephine Daunt and Imelda Staunton as Susan Dervish. With Bill Paterson as Mackie, Kate Buffery as Elizabeth, and Rupert Van Sittart as James. Episode 1. After the ball is over.
Miss Susan Dervish?
That's correct.
And this passport was issued...
At the British Embassy in Paris. Is there something the matter with it?
No, simply that there's no record of your making the outward journey.
That's because I didn't make it by orthodox means. Oh, I think that's my train.
Welcome to England then, miss.
Yes, and you're welcome to it too.
Snook, that's the next thing. It's a man-eating fish, apparently. So we'll be getting our own back.
And what does it taste of?
Not very much, according to Jimmy. A bit like whale meat, but in a different colour tin. Say what you like about the war, but at least you could be killed with a full stomach.
Ladies, are you ready to order?
Afternoon tea, I think, Josephine?
Oh,
it's on me. I've got extra coupons. Now, is the milk powdered?
I'm afraid so, Mum.
Then without, please.
Mum.
Oh, Elizabeth, you shouldn't. It was I who invited you, after all.
Nonsense. It's just so good to see you. Now tell me, how's Covent Garden?
Well, it's not Mayfair.
But so much more vital, isn't it? The market and so on.
I suppose so. But basically, it's cheaper.
Oh, my dear Josephine.
Still, perfectly acceptable.
If there's anything I can do...
Well, perhaps there is.
What? Tell me, please, anything.
I was wondering whether Jimmy needed anyone.
Oh, you want to go back to work? Oh, God, how stupid of me. Of course you do.
He heads a rather large department, doesn't he? Perhaps if there was a vacancy.
How brave of you to ask, and how idiotic of me not to have offered. After all, you've worked together before.
I didn't like to approach him directly. I know how busy he must be.
Josephine, not another word. Consider it done.
Your tea, ladies?
Oh, thank you.
Penny Forum?
What?
Your thoughts. What's running through that pretty brain, eh?
None of your business.
I know, but I'm a mind reader, ain't I? Can't help it. And I'm getting a single word. Stockings.
Stockings?
And I'm here to answer your prayers. Look at those. Sheer nylon, 15 deniers. 5 bob a pair, if you could get them, which you can't. But you can from me, see?
Will you go away, please?
No, I was sitting here before you was. And there's a ladies-only compartment at the end of the carriage, which you didn't choose. So, what about a deal? I could lower the price to 2 and 6 under certain conditions.
Perhaps I will go to the ladies-only compartment after all.
Oh.
Jimmy's always telling me not to worry, but I'd go back to work myself at the drop of a hat. What does it look like otherwise, that I married him for his money?
I'm sure nobody's saying that, Elizabeth.
Oh, tongues wag, you wouldn't believe. But I'm afraid my modelling days are well over now. And I'm not qualified for anything else. Besides, I seem to spend most of my time running round after Charles.
Oh, Charles, yes. What's he doing these days?
Very little. Never be a stepmother, Josephine, particularly not to a wayward 19-year-old. Oh, no. Isn't that Bellissima they're demolishing?
I'm afraid it is. It must have been bomb damaged. It was such a beautiful building, too.
Just as well I parked on this side of the road. Can I give you a lift anywhere?
No, thanks. I'll walk home.
Then we'll see you tomorrow at the flat.
I'm very grateful, Elizabeth.
Rot. You're a friend, Josephine.
.48 made of ale. There you go.
But where is it?
In that gap between 46 and 50, I should say.
But when? I lived here all through the Blitz.
Probably a V2. Now, thinking about it, it was here last week. Never tell these days, can you? Must have come down overnight. Anywhere else I can take you?
Oh, I don't know. An accommodation agency, I suppose.
Someone will have to pay, and it will be you. When did this arrive, Daisy?
It came under the door while you were out. I'm frightened, Mum.
You don't have to be. There's a clear explanation. As I said, it's the work of a crank.
Even so.
And clearly for the previous occupant. Good Lord, how long have we been together? Do you really think I have anything to hide?
No, Mum.
Then come on, Daisy. What about dinner?
Right away, Mum.
There has been treachery at work. Someone will have to pay. And it will be you.
Homes fit for heroes, that's our slogan. Mm-hmm. And by God, we're going to provide them. Come over to the window. Look, what can you see?
The whole of central London.
Like a mouthful of half-decayed teeth, thanks to the Luftwaffe. But it's an opportunity, can't you see? It's no good mourning the buildings we've lost. We have to put up new ones. That's the challenge.
I'm sure you're up to it, Jimmy.
I am, as ever. Truth is, Joe, look, can I get you a drink?
It's a bit early, isn't it?
Well, I'm going to have one. B&S. Come on, join me. Truth is, I never planned to go into government. But when they wound up the outfit, I was at a loose end.
Me too.
I bet you were. And then when the Ministry of Works came up with this offer, well, it was too tempting to refuse. Here, bottoms up.
Cheers.
And of course, I'd love to have you working with us.
Would you?
I'm not saying we'll be as close as in the old special ops days. I've already got a personal assistant, but I'll find something fairly decent for you. Don't you worry. God, it's good to see you again, Joe.
And you, Jimmy.
Yes. Look, I'm hoping Liz will be home soon. And Charles, you haven't seen him for a long while.
Elizabeth implied she was wet nursing him, rather.
Yes, well, he's always been a bit wild. Love him dearly, my own flesh and blood, but, well, she tries to keep tabs on him.
That's good of her.
It is, damn good of her, considering he's not her son. Another drink.
I've hardly touched this.
Excuse me if I do. We knew what we were fighting for, didn't we?
I'm sorry?
Special operations. We knew where we were. And this housing thing, same clear-cut lines. That's what attracted me to it. Mud in your eye.
Jimmy, I'm really very grateful.
There's a reunion of some sort. Today, I think. Field agents down the road in Victoria somewhere.
Oh.
Didn't think I'd go, though. Always look forward, eh?
Oh, just be careful for the guests to warm
and
up.
And here they are, the prodigals.
Just drop them in the bedroom, Charles.
Ah, Josephine caught you.
Elizabeth.
So, Jimmy, is it all fixed?
Ah, the shouting.
Oh, excellent.
You've been shopping.
Insofar as there's anything at all to shop for, but where's my package carrier got to? Charles!
What is it?
Charles, remember me? Josephine Daunt.
What?
Oh, yes, yes.
Come on, Charles, that's not very sociable.
Ooh, are we drinking already? Splendid.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.